Hi everyone. So as we have seen and we've covered a lot of activities of UI automation dot browser activities, and we'll be covering the remaining ones and how we can use them in our use cases. So without much ado, let's quickly get into the demo. So we have the attached browser and the refresh browser, the last activity which we saw in the previous video. So we'll now be covering the set web attribute activity. So it sets the value of a specified web attribute. So let's see how it works. So I'll attach it to the Google homepage screen. So it is already attached. Let's see if we have the screen open. We have it. So now, without type into, if I want to fill in anything here that I want to set the value of this web attribute, which is this text box or the search box, how do I do it? I do it by using set web attribute. So I'll indicate the element and I'll say that I have to set the value of this particular attribute. So I'll be setting the value that I have to set the value. And what value do you want it to be? That you want to set that particular search box to which value? If I say I want to set it to learn RPA. Okay, so let's see how does it works. So I'll click on save and I'll click on run. And there's no type into or anything typing or clicking involved. I am just setting the attribute of this search box to a value, which is learn RPA. So I guess the value is now set, and yes, it's learn RPA. So this way you can set the value of any web attribute without using type into. Now, there are many a times when the ID of a particular web attribute keeps changing dynamically with the loading of the page. Then how do you deal with it? So this is rpachallenge.com aside. So I'll show that how the ID keeps changing. I'll open the developer console by clicking on F12. Now, let's see this company name field. I'll select it over here. And you see the ID as per now is MIVGRN. So that's our ID, MIVGRN, MVGRN, sorry. Now, if I click on refresh, the ID would get changed. Now, if I indicate to company name, now what's the ID? It's W4L71. So how do we deal this thing in browser if the ID of a particular field keeps changing dynamically? We cannot use type into or we cannot use set web attribute because the ID is changing. Then what to do? In that case, what we can do is we can use anchor base. So in that case, what we can do is we can use anchor base. So we will type in anchor base. We will drag it over here. We'll drag it inside an attached browser because if multiple tabs are open or multiple screen is open. So to identify that in which screen it has to search. So how does this work? This is anchor that you'll have to provide a base to next to which it will search. So what we're going to do is we will drag in a find element here and we will indicate that next to this company name you'll have to type in the value. So if we see the selector here, so it's company name, so that's never gonna change. The label would always be company name even if its ID is changing. And in the next, you can type into or you can have a set attribute, whatever you want to. You can even use set attribute and you can even use type into. And then over here, you'll be typing your company name. So now over here, if I type ABC, BAC or ABC. Okay. And don't forget to define the scope of your browser as well. So let's see if it's getting validated. It is getting validated. So that's all. Now, if we run this, okay. So we have attached browser, we have our anchor base. So it will first find company name, and corresponding to that particular label, it will find the text box where it has to enter the company name. So now let's just execute it and see how it works. So over here we have the company name empty, and the position also keeps on changing. If you have noticed, the company name was initially here, then it went down here, now it's up over here. So that also keeps changing. So let's check it now. So how does this anchor base work? We will see in debug mode that what's the way it works out. So it will first go to find element. It wouldn't execute this whole anchor base at once. It will first find the element label, and next it will go into type into, and then it will find the company name, and it will type the company name here, you can see. So it doesn't matter even if the ID keeps changing, or it doesn't matter even the field place, the place of the field keeps changing. It will find the element if it's present on the screen and type the desired text on it. So that is how you deal in if the IDs on the browser keeps changing dynamically with each refresh of the page. You can use anchor base. If the find element is also not stable, you can use find relative element. That relative to this element, you'll have to type something. So that's all for this video. The remaining activities would be covered in the next video. Till then, stay tuned and happy learning.